Good morning. Today is September the 9th, and we're in Acts chapter 1, verse 4 through 8, and without power. The title of this is kind of opposite to what it says. Jesus talked in his Gospels. He said, go to Jerusalem and tarry there, wait there until you've been endued with own power from on high. And he says, you don't know the minute, the second, or the hour, but the Holy Spirit is going to come upon you to be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Samaria, and to the uttermost ends of the earth. You know, I tell you this devotional this morning with great sadness and with great joy. There are those on this earth that confess to know Jesus Christ as the Son of the living God, and that they're born again, they're baptized with water baptism, the water baptism of the repentance of John. But they have not been infilled with the presence of God Himself by the Holy Ghost. And you're going to say, what in the world are you talking about this morning? I'm talking about Jesus telling us in John 14, 16, He said, I pray the Father, He will send the Comforter. I must go, that it is expedient that I go, that the Spirit shall come, and He shall infill and be within and without you all the days of your life and forever and ever and ever. God Himself on flesh with power. If you ever want to do the things of God, you need power to do that. Do you know, if you ever read Acts the 19th chapter where in about the 11th or 12th verse, you know, they said that Paul wore handkerchiefs and aprons upon his body, and they would take them and place them on the sick and the afflicted, and devils and demons and sickness would flee because of the anointing that was on what was being worn by. That same anointing, the Holy Spirit, was given to those disciples in that day. Apollos had been there preaching, and there was 12 disciples, and they had received Christ as their Savior. Jesus had become the Lord in their heart. They were baptized with water baptism, with water, John's repentance, it says. And then Paul asked them, he says, have you heard of the Holy Ghost? And they said, we haven't even heard of Him. He said, I want to lay hands on you, and power from on high is going to come in you. And we know that in Acts chapter 10, that when Peter preached at Cornelius' house, the Holy Spirit was given 10 years after the Pentecost day in Acts chapter 2 was given to the Gentile. And we know, whether they be Gentile, Jew, or Greek, or whatever, here the Holy Spirit, through the laying of Paul's hands, the Spirit of the living God, entered into these believers. And it says they prophesied and spoke with a heavenly language. And then Paul told them what about all that. And then later on it shows there, it says that these seven sons of Sceva, they went out to cast this devil out of this man. And when they went out there, he said, Jesus I know, Paul I know, but who are you? And this devil that was in this person beat up the seven sons of this Jewish priest. And they went out naked and hurt and bruised, it said. When you go out against the enemy every day in your daily walk, if you're not suited up with the whole armor of God, Ephesians chapter 6, 10 through 18, if you've not prayed and built up your holy faith, as in Jude 19 through 24. If you've not exercised what God is telling you, don't go without power. You're going to get your brains beat out. You may be like an insurance salesman or a car dealer. You call enough names and invite enough people to your showroom, you might get someone to buy. Or if you're selling vacuum cleaners or doing whatever you do, working at Walmart, you might get someone to buy. But if you really want to receive power, you go and ask God to fill you. Luke 11, 13 says, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those that ask? How have you asked Him today to fill you with His very presence? There will be evidence if He's there. May this revelation be great to you and all those around you in Jesus' name.